Joining us in the studio, Ambassador Garang Diing Akuong is South Sudan's ambassador to the United States and the non-resident ambassador to Canada. He was formerly a lawmaker in the National Legislative Assembly of South Sudan. Ambassador, thanks for joining us.
Thank you. Let me start
by asking you to give us your assessment of the security situation in South Sudan right now.
Yeah, from my own perspective and from the government take is that the security situation is fairly good. The regions are quiet. The capital is quiet. The government and the president are in control of the situation, except some incursions that are launched by the rebels from time to time in Nasser and a place called Jungle State recently. Apart from that, the situation is quiet.
You say it's quiet, but there are reports that there are thousands of people who've been displaced, hundreds of people have been killed in the latest flare-up of violence.
Yeah, I think the displacement is true, and this is because of the activities of the rebels around Juba, because when Dr. Riek Machar left Juba, he made a promise that he was going to come back and take over Juba. So they were having a lot of activities around Juba, including looting of the properties of the citizens, and then also the recruitment of child soldiers in the area. So these activities have led into the destabilization in around Juba, and therefore people had to leave, looking for a safer places. The fighting that took place in Juba, yes, some losses in life have occurred on both sides, mm-hmm. the government and the rebels. Apart from that, everything is quite good.
What is the humanitarian situation right now? How are the people who've been displaced being accommodated?
Yeah, there are two sets of this displacement that happened. Some people panic and ran into UN camps inside Juba, and these are the people that are being taken care of by the UN by feeding them and giving them services inside the UN camp. There are people also who went to the charities like churches, mm-hmm. and these people have been supported by the government and the churches, but most of them have returned into their homes. A few fled into Uganda and are now in northern Uganda, and the UN made pledges for the support of these people who have fled to northern Uganda.
There is a very large UN peacekeeping force in the country, 12,000 troops, and there are plans to increase that 12,000 by another 4,000. President Salva Kiir is not confident that the UN can hold the peace, can defuse the situation in South Sudan. Let's take a listen to what he had to say.
South Sudan is not instinctively or automatically against IGAD and UN involvement in this agreement. We welcome any assistance. We are attentive to advice, but assistance requires dialogue. It should not turn into an imposition that becomes an intervention.
Why does the president have such little confidence in the UN?
No, the president doesn't have a little confidence in the UN. There is a big presence of UN, as you mentioned, in South Sudan,
right,
in terms of peacekeepers, military personnel, in terms of civilian personnel
in
South Sudan.
In that brief statement
but
he made,
what the president is saying and the people of South Sudan are saying is that the issue of intervention in South Sudan needs dialogue between South Sudan and
right.
international community. And as a member state, any intervention into a member state needs the consent of that state. As a principle in peacekeeping, the consent
but
of
South
the state
Sudan
is required.
Did give its consent
but,
to the troops.
Yeah, we gave, in principle, we agreed that, okay, if Riek Machar needs protection, if the NGOs need protection, if the displaced people need protection, then we agree in principle. But what is the mandate that will have to be given to them? And also, what is the duration of that protection? And also, what is the fund? Where is the funding is going to come? From where are the troops going to come? These are our take. But the resolution that was passed by the Security Council ignored South Sudan concerns, ignored some members' concerns in the Security Council, ignored the concerns of that were expressed by China, by the Egyptians, by the Russians, by the Venezuelans, and a couple of other members. That resolution was not a unanimous resolution. It was passed by a majority, but some people expressed serious concern because the government consultations were not taken on board. So the president is saying that, and we in South Sudan were saying that we are not against the UN coming to South Sudan. UN is already there. Right. We are not against the IGAD coming to South Sudan, but we need to dialogue. The resolution called for the takeover of Juba by a force that to be deployed, and that is, we say that that will undermine the sovereignty of the country. It calls for the takeover of the airport. It calls for the takeover of the inlet and outlet of the capital. So even the president, when he goes traveling, might have to contact you and say, look, I am traveling in a country that is sovereign. It is not feasible. And these are the concerns that were expressed by some members in the Security Council.
If we look at the current dispute now between government forces and the rebels, what are the diplomatic options that are open to resolve this?
Yeah, we are saying that this current peace agreement, despite the faults that are in the peace agreement, that is the best option we have now. Any other option will be going back to war, something that is not palatable to the people of South Sudan, neither to the region. So we are sticking to this peace agreement. With the new partner that has emerged from the SPLM-IO, we are fairly continuing implementing with the implementation of the peace agreement. So we are saying that the parties should be kept engaged. The region should keep also supporting us. The international community should continue to support us. But to send some negative signals from the international community or from the UN, this is going to implicate the problem more than it is now. So we are saying that, look, let us come together. Let us look into the regional prospect of trying to involve in South Sudan. Take the concern of South Sudan on board. This is what we are saying.
Now, China has massive investments in your country, plays a big role in its economic development. Do you believe that China can play a key role in helping South Sudan achieve peace?
I think that the people of South Sudan and the government of South Sudan appreciate the role of China in South Sudan. China played a very critical role and it continues to play that one. First, China is the biggest investor in South Sudan, billions of dollars, especially in the oil sector. China is one of the few countries that has been standing with the government of South Sudan and people of South Sudan during this crisis through humanitarian assistance, through the peacekeeping that has been deployed, through some loans to the government of South Sudan, that even building the Juba International Airport, giving it a new good face. It was done by China involvement in South Sudan. Mm-hmm. So we think that China has a critical role to play internationally and regionally and even nationally. So there's no doubt that people of South Sudan are really seeing China as a good friend in times of bad things when they go bad in South Sudan, in times of good things that when they're happening in South Sudan. So we will never do away with China.
Right. Ambassador, thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you very much.